shows these ugly dancer feet I got? Well, I'll have you know that I found someone who loves my ugly feet. I know, right? Not only that, but one that will dance with me all night as if we got hella stamina from going to the gym often, and you know I don't go to the gym often. Okay, you know I don't go to the gym at all, but that's besides the point. Either way, it feels real good to be with somebody who's willing to work it out with me. Mama, the first time my lover ever kissed me, I felt ready to do it again and again and again, till even when we're like 92 and our hair has grown thin and our memory has begun to escape us. Mama, I think I'm ready to love in a way that I've always been afraid of. Mama, you know the sweetest words I've ever heard? The ones that make me feel the most confident in myself and secure are the ones you've been singing to me since I was still new to this earth. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Mama, my lover feels like sunshine. She's bright enough to remind me that even if the clouds are gray, the sun still shines somewhere else. Sometimes we're just not there to see it, and sometimes all the light we actually need is inside of ourselves. We're just too afraid to be it. Mama, did you know that the sun always makes good on its promise? That every day that we wake up, we get to rejoice that the light came back? Well, my mom in love was someone who taught me that. My lover smiles with the sun, and I wake up every day to it, to a warm body and a familiar face that is excited to see me whenever I come back to this place from wherever it is that my dreams take me. Mama, I want to love. I want to love, and I don't ever want to stop loving, even if it means that the rest of the world hates me. Mama, I'm in love with a spirit that's made a home in a woman's body, and I'm not ashamed to say so. Not afraid to know a love that stays close and holds me down and holds my hand, but don't hold me back. One that is bold and close to God and black and sweet like Sunday mornings in the scalp room. Mama, I found love, and it don't hurt, and the world feels safe for once. And my lover makes me want to write poems that aren't about my pain for once. With my lover, I don't have to think about my ugly feet or where my breath might stink in the morning. My lover will still rush to kiss me, will still remind me that all the love I seek in this world is me. And with my lover, I don't feel weak. I feel ready to shout from every peak of every mountaintop that a love like this exists and that I made my way to it and it's made its way to me. Mama, my lover is free. Is a personified 1 Corinthians 13, is a compilation of all the God and glory right next to you that I have ever seen, and it is a woman. And to the rest of the world, that may not make sense. And to you, it might just be one more thing to accept, one more thing, reason to stand up for me, one more reason to understand something about your seed that you feel is needed, no matter how many times you succeeded at coming around to trust me. Mama, it feels damn good to know that God made somebody in this world to love me the way I need it. And it took loving you and being loved by you to get me here. Mama, your daughter is queer and proud to be. And I hope the fact that I can love at all is enough reason for you to still be proud of me.
But wait. You don't want to do like one more? Just real quick? Let me get you one more, right?
Okay, well, I'll do this one that I do all the time because I usually just do it all the time. I wrote it when I was about 16 years old and edited it over and over and over again as I grow. It's one of the first poems I ever like wrote and shared in front of people. So I'd like to share it with y'all if that's okay.
Yeah.
Okay, it's called Open Letter. Dear Daddy, what does being whole feel like? See, a place in my heart is empty, so I know what holes feel like, and I've always seen myself as a puzzle with missing pieces, as a girl bred on hostility with no knowledge of what peace is. I found a picture of you and my mother, and on the back it said, to Mom, I know this isn't what you call perfect, but I hope one day you'll accept what makes me happy. Dear Daddy, I know what it's like to find joy in a boy. I too have placed my heart in the hands of men who only had intentions to destroy all that is beautiful. And I believe them when they called me beautiful, said they loved me, but never meant it. How he used my vulnerability as a key for between my legs entrance, and he took my pride with clenched fists and harsh words. Dear Daddy, You weren't there to protect it, dear daddy. I'm in love with a boy with a 6 a.m. smile. But dear daddy, just like you, I'll always be a doubter that he loves me too. But I believe in him like I believe in you, like I believe in stars, and stars are dead, but they still seem to shed light on dark nights. My heart fights my mind on a daily basis, and your face is hard to relate with. Guess I look more like my mother. Dear daddy, did you leave because I remind you too much of her? Did you not know how to love me because you never truly loved her? See, I spent my life trying to come up with an excuse for you giving up your first child. They say time heals all, but 18 years is. They say time heals all, but 19 years is. They say time heals all, but 20 years is. They say time heals all, but 21 years is. They say time heals all, but 22 years is. They say time heals all, but 23 years is. Quite a while to hurt. It's gotten old, and I'm a fire that's burned cold. Dear daddy, I only see myself as glitter. But he caresses the perimeter of my being like I'm gold. He sees a sparkle in my eyes, but he does not know that it's only because I've turned them into lighthouses to guide you home. And I've kept my hand open, hoping that one day you'll fill the spaces in between my fingers with the promises that you never kept. See, I look at you as lost, don't want to believe you truly left. Dear daddy, I'm scared. The next time I'll see you is in your death, so I accept whatever apology that you never actually said, and I still pray that a thought of me comes to your head and you realize that I'm not a child anymore. That I've understood what heartbreak felt like far before I ever loved someone, that I was forced from virgin to whore because I loved someone, dear daddy. I've written poems about boys that resemble your reflection. I've written poems about dysfunction and lost affection. As for ones written for you, this is number 27, and it's the only one that I've yet to actually forget. And I stand here in front of a crowd, and you're still not here to listen. I guess ignorance, you don't know what you're missing. I guess ignorance is bliss, but mama raised a queen, so we gonna be all right. And when that darkness comes back round, she gonna be my light. Taught me how to let this pain package me as a diamond, and I'm gonna shine so bright, dear daddy. I stand here and speak, and you're still not here to, just off the top. I found a picture of you and my mother, and on the back it said to mom, I know this isn't what you call perfect, but I hope one day you'll accept what makes me happy. Maybe she meant a little girl with lighthouse eyes, hair slightly nappy, and a soul to remind her of all that is true, of all the strength that is her in me, despite the pain that is you. I am whole, and I am worthy. And you're still not here to hear me speak, so maybe, well, maybe I shouldn't bother. But I will stand here like, look what God has made of me, sincerely. Your daughter.
Yeah.